I lied. In one of my previous videos, I explained why I quit my six-figure job. I explained how over the years I've learned three very important lessons that made me decide to leave everything behind and start building a life I actually want. But I wasn't completely honest. Now let me explain. You see, as I said in that video, there's three lessons I learned that made me decide to quit my job. The first one being, your permanent job is not so permanent. Your permanent job is not as safe as you think it is. And the second one is that success in your career means that you get to do work that feels like play, fulfills a purpose, and gets you paid. And the third one is that you should get paid for your output and not your input. If you haven't seen that video, you might want to check it out as it's one of my most watched videos. It might be valuable to you. So I decided to leave behind the whole office life and start building a brand through YouTube, through content creation. But as I said, I lied a little bit. I did not actually make $170,000. No, I did. The salary was actually true. I did not lie about my salary. Well, I did make that salary as a freelancer, meaning I have to pay for my own insurance, I have to pay for my own pension. When I take a day off or when I'm sick, I don't get paid anything, absolutely. And it's all before taxes. And since I live in Holland, they really like to take a big cut of your salary. So it does sound a little bit more sensational than it really is. Just wanted to get it out there. But that's not what I lied about. The thing I lied about is that there's only three reasons that made me quit my job. Because there's actually a fourth reason. And probably the most important reason I actually did decide to leave everything behind, start traveling the world, start focusing on building a brand through content creation. And today I'm sharing that lesson with you. The real reason I quit my job. It all started back in 2020.
The breaking news, stay at home.
Countries had to go in lockdown and everyone started working from home. Got him. Fucking mosquitoes. Even though before the whole pandemic, there was already a slow trend towards working from home becoming more accepted, the lockdowns really accelerated this move from working at the office 5 days in a week to working completely remote. And guess what happened? Employees started slacking off, right? They started working less as managers didn't have any control over what they were doing, right? Wrong. Employees started actually being more productive. In fact, there have been multiple studies showing that working from home actually increased productivity with 13%, meaning working remotely has proven to be successful and will change the way we think about work forever. Nowadays, whenever I look on job websites or recruiters approach me through LinkedIn, I see the same thing over and over again. The option to work fully remote. This was not even a thing a couple of years ago. Now you can literally start working at a company without ever going to the company. Maybe except for picking up your laptop or getting onboarded. Everything is virtual now, meaning you can work from anywhere in the world. Since you're not confined to a physical location, you don't have to live in a big expensive city anymore. And if you decide to live outside the big expensive city, you also now don't have to commute to work anymore. In fact, it means you don't even have to live in the same country as your employer. As long as you can do your job properly, you can do it from any place in the world. In fact, with your salary, you can probably live as a king in some country with a lower cost of living, like Thailand, for example. But if this is all true, that I can now work as a data analyst from basically anywhere in the world, then why did I still decide to quit my job? These mosquitoes are eating me alive. Well, this brings me to the dark side of remote work. See, this trend of working remotely has a big drawback that made me decide to quit my job and start a completely different career from scratch. Let me explain. Since remote work has become the new normal, people from any country can work for any company. Meaning that while every data analyst, programmer, software developer, software engineer is happy to work from home, employers can also hire people from any country. They don't have to hire someone that lives nearby the office. They can hire anyone in the world. These mosquitoes are dumb. There's different types of mosquitoes here in Thailand. There's the really fast ones. You can't get them, but this one is a stupid one. They're so slow. Employers also are no longer confined to the physical location of the office. They no longer have to hire someone that lives nearby the office. They can literally hire anyone in the world. And this has already been happening, of course, in the last decade with Indian call centers, for example. But now this globalization of recruitment will also accelerate, meaning you are no longer in competition with just employees from your country. You're now in competition with the whole world. And overall, this is actually a good thing. Because this means your company can now hire someone from India, Russia, Argentina for a much lower cost than if they were to hire you. Meaning they could potentially hire up to 5-6 data analysts instead of hiring just one, being you. And this is what I call a win-win-lose situation. A win for the company as they get to cut their costs. A win for skilled workers in countries with lower costs of living. But it's a loss for you as your job, your salary, and your skills are now in competition with the whole world instead of just your country. As if the rise of artificial intelligence and the threat of AI taking over your tech job wasn't bad enough already. So I asked myself, do I want to be in this increasing competition for the rest of my life? No. But I mean, you will always have competition in some way, right? Yeah, but not really. Because I learned there is a way to escape competition completely. You escape competition through authenticity. It's a tweet by Naval Ravikant that perfectly encompasses the fourth lesson I've learned that made me quit my job. You see, while the whole world can compete for the same job as yours, nobody can compete in being you. You are the best in being you. And normally, that would have been useless advice. But in the internet era, just being you can be turned into a business. Joe Rogan became a podcast and many people followed. PewDiePie became a YouTube gamer and many people followed, all by being themselves. So if you can find a way to monetize being yourself, you have escaped competition by being authentic. And it's a two bird, one stone situation. Is that how you call it? You know what I mean. Because on the one hand, you're getting paid for being yourself rather than being someone else. And I immediately think of office politics, sucking up to the manager. No, you can't say that in an office. You have to behave in a... No, no more of that. Now you can be your authentic, true self and getting paid for it. And the other thing is, by being yourself, you no longer have to worry for any competition. You don't have to worry for being outcompeted by anyone in the world because there's only one you. So this escape from increasing competition by being myself has made me quit my job. I now no longer have to think about being outskilled by anyone in the world. I can now finally express my true self through my creativity, all while getting paid for it. And I know, but what about all the other YouTubers in the same niche as you? They're basically your direct competitors. Yeah, but not really. Because although we all make videos and basically fight for your attention, eventually the people that end up watching your videos and stay to watch your videos, they do it because of you. I mean, there are thousands, if not tens of thousands of personal development YouTube channels out there. Great ones, really big ones. But I only watch a handful of them. Also because I don't have infinite amount of time to watch every single YouTube video there is. But also because I resonate the most with those 4 or 5 personal development YouTubers that I enjoy watching. I'm sure those other YouTubers make really great content as well, but I just don't resonate with them as a person. And that's fine for them and that's fine for me. Every YouTuber attracts his own niche and his own audience by being himself. And that's what I'm trying to do with my channel, basically. I've quit my job, I'm trying to escape the 9-to-5 while traveling the world, and I'm sharing my lessons along this journey, hoping to provide enough value to make a living out of this. Now, if you think that's valuable, or if you want to become part of this journey, subscribe. Also, follow me on Instagram. I post a lot of cool photos and personal stories, and I hope you like the video, guys. See you in the next one. Cheers. And not for the value I provide. For the value. Why the fuck do I keep saying this? Nowadays, whenever I look on a job website or a recruiter approach me. Now, if you think you might find this value, you might find this value. If you might think, if you, what the fuck?